Thank you. Our service begins on page 2 of your bulletin and page 355 in the Book of Common Prayer. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. God, you taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit, that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the reading.
Today's first reading is from the book of Zechariah, chapter 9, verses 9 through 12, found on page 3 of your bulletin. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you. Triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem. And the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm today is Psalm 145, verses 8 through 15. Let us read them together. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great kindness. The Lord is loving to everyone, and his compassion is over all his works. All your works praise you, O Lord, and your faithful servants bless you. They make known the glory of your kingdom and speak of your power, that the people may know of your power and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Your dominion endures throughout all ages. The Lord is faithful in all his words and merciful in all his deeds. The Lord upholds all those who fall. He lifts up those who are bowed down.
Psalm 145, Second reading is from the book of Romans. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now if I do what I do not want, it is no longer that I do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's stand and sing together sequence hymn, Awake My Soul and With the Sun.
Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "To what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time, Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Let us pray. O Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. Today's gospel, Jesus begins the gospel by asking a question. To what can I compare this generation? You see, God became incarnate and became to earth. He came to earth in a place where there was tons of upheaval. First century Palestine was one of those places that I would have not wanted to be. It was crazy. You had not only religious things going on, but you had political things going on as well. If you all know the history, the Romans have taken over the place, and there's a lot of people who don't like the Romans, but there's some who do. The Sanhedrin, who work with the temple, they never had so much power to when the Romans got there. You've got political factions, you've got zealots, you've got all these other different factions that are trying to vie for power, and all of them are intent on chaos. All of them. You got the Sadducees and the Pharisees. They don't like each other. I remember in seminary it was a joke. How do we remember what the Sadducees are? Well, they don't believe in the resurrection, so they're sad, you see. I know. I thought the same thing when I heard it, but I never forgot it. Right. But the Sadducees and the Pharisees are arguing over what is the true religion. And on the scene becomes John the Baptist. And he tries to prepare the way of God. And he tells people, repent, metanoia, take a 90-degree turn, go do something different because the world around us is not working. It's crazy out there. There's violence. There's tons of uprisings and upheaval, and people are dying. They rejected him. The poor didn't. The poor went, we need this stuff to change. So they began to flock like crazy to John the Baptist. They went down and was baptized into repentance. And they prepared themselves for Jesus. And as Jesus comes upon the scene, a man bearing peace, a man preaching love, they hate him. They can't stand him. Why? Because he doesn't do the things that I want them to do. He doesn't do the things that I think the way they should be done. He heals on the Sabbath. He doesn't care about the politics. He doesn't. He cares about people's heart. And like he says in the first thing, John didn't come eating or drinking. They said he had a demon. I come eating and drinking. I'm a glutton and a drunk. And I thought to myself, as we celebrate this 4th of July weekend, what a difference this weekend is for me than it was in 1976. In 1976, I was a sophomore in high school, and we had a bell that was right outside my house. And I remember that in a certain time that day on the 4th of July, we all rang bells. And I remember standing outside of my porch ringing this bell. This bell was important to me. When my mother rang the bell, that meant come home. It didn't matter. And I could hear that bell even when I was on my motorcycle 2 miles away. I could hear that bell, right? But I remember ringing that bell and thinking about what it meant to be an American. Thinking about all the hardships that we've come through. And thinking about what it was that caused us to make our break with Britain. And I begin to think about how the Constitution was written. And I begin to think about how it's not perfect. But there's an ideal there that all men are created equal. That all people are equal. There was an ideal there that has been imperfectly put to the test for 226 years. And as I begin to think about that, I think about the hope that I had in my heart. I begin to think about 9/11, and I begin to think about those planes that go into the tower, and how the police in New York and the firefighters ran to those towers. They didn't hold back, and many of them lost their lives trying to save people's lives, and how we went from that to people hating police now and assassinating them. We've had 50 police officers shot in the head in the last 3 months. And as I begin to think about those ideals, I begin to think about Jesus. Jesus came preaching peace. They didn't want peace. They wanted a change in government. They wanted to be on top and have somebody else on the bottom. And Jesus knows that about people's hearts. Today, the violence that's going on is not justified. I don't care what it is. Is there injustice in this country? Yes. And there will be injustice 200 years from now because humans are not perfect. But the ideals that our forefathers fought for are something to keep. Jefferson and Washington and all these people, and I see the statues coming down, and I think they did the same thing to Jesus. They didn't want to hear about peace. Today, I was talking to someone about, we have to have peace. They're like, it's not a time for peace. Yes, it is, church. Yes, it is. It's a time for peace. It's a time for God to be in our hearts. I don't know about you, but I'm tired. I'm tired of the pandemic. I'm tired of not being able to go to Florida and see my granddaughter. My youngest granddaughter is walking and talking, and I can't see her. And my heart is broken. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of the violence. I'm tired of the looting. I'm tired of Americans at each other's throat. And as I listen to that, I hear Jesus say, come. Come. You're weary? I got it. I understand it. It's not about the politics. It's not about all that stuff. It's about our hearts. And Jesus wants to come and put peace in our hearts. I've said for 7 years that I've been here that I believe that there's a revival coming in this nation, and it starts in Collegeville. And I still believe that because we have to be people that see the glass as half full and not half empty. What happened to George Floyd in Minnesota was wrong. Everybody agrees with that. But not all police are brutal. Amen? Not all police are brutal. I ask this, Heavenly Father, that we on this 4th of July weekend, that we reevaluate our place in this society. What are we doing to bring about the kingdom of God? What are we doing to make this life a better place for all people? What would Jesus say about this generation? I'm afraid. I'm afraid what he would say. I'm afraid how we ignore the violence in some parts of our society and applaud it in others. I applaud no violence. I want the Holy Spirit to move. I want him to change my heart. I want him to change your heart. I want him to change your heart, all our hearts. Why? Because that is the only way it's going to work. We cannot have God in our own politics. We can't have God and have it our way. Being a Christian is taking your life and giving it away. Taking your will and giving it away. Giving it to Jesus Christ and have him change our hearts. I pray that I have the hope again. At 60 years old, I'm getting ready to turn 60 years old. I want the hope of that 14-year-old, that 16-year-old kid who was outside ringing a bell. I want that hope again. I want to believe that our experiment in liberty means something. But most of all, I want to believe that Jesus Christ is going to take us where he needs to go. What does the kingdom of God look like? I have no idea. But I guarantee it's not dependent on who's a Republican or a Democrat in office. Can I get an amen on that? Amen. It doesn't matter. I can guarantee that it's not going to be, a kingdom of God is not going to be a place where people are afraid to walk out their door because of violence. Or afraid to get stopped by the police. Does this country need to change? Yes. It needs to change. But we Christians can bring about that change if we quit focusing on that. Are you weary? Are your burdens seem heavy? Mine does. If they're weary, let's put it on Jesus. Let's come right here at this altar and let's lay it down right there. Because that's where it belongs. Let's lay it down. And then let's pray for peace and work for peace. Work for justice. Do those things that our baptismal covenant ask us to do. It's time, church. It's time not to be like the rest of the world. I'm frustrated at the leadership of my church. who will not stand up and say that violence is wrong. Violence is wrong. If I'm going to be the only voice, I'm going to say it. Violence is wrong. Looting is wrong. Rioting is wrong. If nobody else wants to say it, I'm going to. Because Jesus Christ lives in my heart, and I know that he doesn't want that to happen. May the Holy Spirit of God move in us, make us willing to change, willing to be people that will live the life that he asks us to live. He's calling. He's standing right here. All that you are weary and have heavy burdens, come, lay it on me. I can take it. Amen. I can take it. And let's work for the kingdom of God. Amen. Amen.
Let us stand and confirm our faith through the words of the Nicene Creed, found on page 358 of the Book of Common Prayer, page 5 of your bulletin. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people. In peace we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work,
for our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who seek justice, freedom, and peace. For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression. For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy. For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth. For Michael, our presiding bishop, Daniel, our bishop, myself as your rector, and Ms. Lou, our deacon, and for all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God and his church. For the special needs and concerns of this congregation.
Heavenly Father, I lift up to you all those who are on the St. James prayer list. I ask you, Lord, to be with those who are sick, those with COVID-19, those with cancer, and those you pray for out loud or in the silence in your heart at this time. Hear us, Lord,
for your mercy is great. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life.
Heavenly Father, On this holiday weekend, we give thanks, Lord, for the ideas of liberty, the ideas of freedom, and the ideas that brought this country into fruition. We ask you, Heavenly Father, that we have the strength and courage to live out those ideas. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
We will exalt you, O God, our King,
and praise your name forever and ever. We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Please add those, either silently or loud at home, for prayers of the departed, for the saints of St. James.
Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them
who put their trust in you. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, in your compassion forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins to our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please stand. And if you're at home, share the peace with your family. May the peace of the Lord be always with you. And also with you. Peace. Peace. Peace.
Peace, O Lord, to you.
Peace. Peace. Announcements. What announcements do we have? Well, we're going to continue to do what we've been doing. Please, we'll be here between 11:30 and 12:30 for people receiving communion. Carol is here. Do you have any announcements for Outreach House?
We desperately need paper towel. Desperately.
Desperately need paper towels, if you didn't hear that. Okay. That sounds good. All right. Food, we're doing okay, right? Doing okay with food?
Okay.
Okay. Good deal. Okay. Good deal. Lauren, do you have anything?
Yes.
Lauren has an announcement.
Hello. So today we are continuing our youth group meetings. 6th through 12th grade is meeting today at 4 o'clock to play a game called Werewolf. We need at least 5 people to play, so come on, join the Zoom meeting, and just have a fun time in fellowship.
All right, we might be the only church in the world where you get together to play Werewolf. I think that's good. Anybody else have anything? Is there birthdays this week that I don't know about? Is it your birthday, Carol? Come up here, I'll stay away from you social distancing wise. But we're gonna pray for Carol on her birthday, and then we're gonna sing her a song. Luckily, you've got Val here and Janice, so it'll sound good, not me singing. If you all here would stand, turn in your prayer books to page 830, and you can get in the shot, Carol, so people can see you at your birthday.
Oh, no, am I in the shot?
There you go. Prayer 50, let us pray. O God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your servant Carol as she begins another year. Grant that she may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen her trust in your goodness all the days of her life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. All right. Anything else to be thankful for or to pray about? You all can be seated. I do have one prayer request. One of the gentlemen who was at Florida State when I was there, his name's Ian Dankman. He's an attorney now. He left Florida State, graduated in 2010, went to law school, and is an attorney in Tampa. Six of their attorneys have COVID-19. Right, it came from Miami, and so he's isolated right now. He's a young man, fairly healthy, but I want to pray for him. I want to pray for Florida, pray for Arizona, pray for all these places, because it's just going rampant. We have been slow to reopen, and I think we've made the right decision. We plan to be back full time on September the 13th, right, which is our first day of church school. We're going to continue. I'm so afraid. I'm looking at the numbers that we're going to go back to red. You know, please be safe there. I detest not being with you all. This hurts my heart. I know it hurts yours too, Lou. We've talked about that more than once. I cannot wait for this place to be overflowing again and hug people. But I don't want to be responsible for anybody getting sick. So please, stay at home. Practice good hygiene. Wash your hands. Don't try not to touch your face, which I do all the time. All right? And just be careful out there because it's dangerous. Pray for our pharmaceuticals. Pray for all those scientists that are working on that. Because I really believe the only way we're going to fix this is to get a vaccine. Amen? I believe so. I don't know what I put in the bulletin, but I'm just going to pick one. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts with praise. Service of Holy Eucharist continues with the Eucharistic Prayer D, found on page 372 in the Book of Common Prayer and page 7 of your bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly right to glorify you, Father, and give you thanks. For you alone are God, living and true, dwelling in light and accessible from before time and forever. Fountain of life and source of all goodness, you made all things and filled them with your blessing. You created them to rejoice in the splendor of your radiance. Countless throngs of angels stand before you to serve you night and day. And beholding the glory of your presence, they offer you your unceasing praise. Joining with them and giving voice to every creature under heaven, we acclaim you and glorify your name as we sing.
Thank you.
proclaim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that in your obedience to you, our Creator, you might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help, so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into a covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us the hope for salvation. Father, you love the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior, incarnate by the Holy Spirit. Born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation. To prisoners, freedom. To the sorrowful, joy. And to fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death, and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world, and to bring the fulfillment, the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to him, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Father, we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and his descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering you from the gifts you've given us, this bread and this cup. We praise you and we bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God. Lord, we pray that your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share in this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice to Christ, to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, preserve it in peace. And grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with St. James and all your saints, who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them, and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." For the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feel in him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. At this time, we'll receive communion in the receiving line. Put on my mask. It's the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Amen. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. For those who can't come to communion but have watched this service, let us pray the prayer for spiritual communion. In the Book of Common Prayer, it states if a person desires to receive the sacrament, but by reason of extreme sickness or physical disability, is unable to eat, drink the bread and wine, that the celebrant is to assure that person that all benefits of communion are received, even though the sacrament is not received with the mouth. During this time of isolation, due to the quarantine, we're unable to gather. This restriction creates a physical disability, causing us to be separated. Despite our separation, we are assured of the benefits of God's grace given to us at the Eucharist. Please pray this prayer with me. My Jesus, I know that you are present in the Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. May you love graciously, forgive unconditionally, and practice radical hospitality. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. Kids at home, let's have the neighbors hear you. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Bye-bye. We love you all.